Assalamu alaikum and good morning guys, how are you? Today we will continue our HSC trainings and we will go through one of the major HSC training, and this training is called the confined space. So when we are talking about the confined space, we will go through some objectives and we will go through some contents which we later on step by step we will consider them and let you understand. So what we will discuss today is about the confined space. The contents are as follows. What is the confined space? We will first discuss. Then we go towards the hazards of the confined space. Then we will go towards the responsibilities. Who is responsible for working in the confined space and how to make the job safer. And the fourth one, we will learn about the precautionary measures. So let's come to the confined space. What is the confined space? Confined space is a space which has a limited entry and exit. It has a limited entry and exit, and there is no permanent occupancy. A person who is doing a job in a confined space, just like a shell container which has one opening, and down the earth if you are doing some job and it has one entrance. So this type of space, if you do the work, you have to do the work in the shifts. The person will not stay over there for a longer time and perform the job. So this is a confined space. When you consider the confined space, there are many things which will come in front of you when working. What are these things? We need to go for the hazards while working in the confined space. What are the hazards? Hazards are the things which you will come in contact when you are working in the confined space. What are these hazards? Toxic gases, presence of the toxic gases. If you are doing a job in a welding job or performing some other kind of a job in an area where there is a use of chemicals in a confined space, so there is a chance of presence of the toxic gases. Geometry. When you are working in a confined space, the geometry is a very important factor which need to be considered, because the person has to perform, if the geometry is not in a suitable way, the person has to do the or perform the job in an awkward position. This will give him some strain, mental tension and stress on the body. So these geometries need to be considered while you are working in the confined space. Then comes the temperature. If you are working in a confined space and the temperature outside is a hot temperature, so then you will get exhaustion inside a confined space. So the temperature should be considered as a factor of hazard in the confined space. Oxygen deficiency. When you go inside any kind of a shell type working place, the oxygen level for inside the working space is very low because there is no continuous supply of the air in that space. So this factor is very important because the oxygen is very mandatory thing for us for taking a breath. So if the oxygen level is very low, so you need some external aids to cope up with this hazard. The last one is the light. When you are working in the confined space, you have limited light. Sometimes you are working in the daytime, you can get a small portion of the light from the point from where you enter and exit. But this light is not enough to perform the work properly if you have to do a work away from the light spots. So you have to consider this factor as a hazard inside the confined space. So when you are performing a work in the confined space, first of you have to conduct a PTW, conduct a JSA, job safety analysis. Then you have to go through some certificates which you have to pass that this working space is enough clear to perform a job in a satisfactory way or in a safer manner. So what type of these things you have to do? Conduct a PTW, JSA, then you have to do a gas testing. Gas testing is done by an authorized gas tester. They are certified persons who have specialization in performing the gas test to monitor the amount of the CO, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, presence of any other toxic gas, sulfur dioxide, presence of H2S, and the level of the oxygen inside. So when you are doing work in the confined space, a gas tester must be present at that space who will continually monitor the values of the toxic gases or value of the gases which are produced as a result of your work in the confined space. And who had, and this authorized gas tester has to record it on the specific certificate. If the things, if the working standards or if the working values parameters for the toxic gases, for the presence of the toxic gases comes to a level, low level exposure limits, so the work will be good and you can perform the work. But if this level of toxic gases are not up to the standard levels of exposure limits, so then you have to wait and make sure that the area becomes clear for working. So when we have to utilize this factor gas testing, if the gas test results are higher than you are required, then you have to go through some artificial means of clearing this space or making this space comfortable for the persons who need to go inside or perform a job. Ventilation. You can ventilate the area or the working space for some period of time to let the fresh air go through that space and remove the toxic gases. But how you can perform the ventilation? You can do some forced draft actions using some blowers or positive suction pumps to or create a vacuum to remove all the toxic gases inside and then pass the fresh air through the whole area where you want to work in a confined space to let the oxygen level go for the working space. But as you are working in a confined space, sometimes the oxygen levels cannot be accommodated, the person or the person have to go down more than the to get the proper level of oxygen. At that time you have to use some secretary aids. These aids are called breathing apparatuses. What type of breathing apparatus you can use? This is called a scuba. Scuba is called self-contained breathing apparatus. This we will later on discuss when we will learn about H2S safety, hydrogen sulfide safety, because hydrogen sulfide is used most of the time in the oil industry. And this training we will later on discuss, where we will discuss these breathing apparatuses, but you get a little knowledge that this is a breathing apparatus which is self-contained. There is an oxygen cylinder, air cylinder in it, where the air is compressed at some pressurized pressure and you can get the pure level of oxygen which you require for respiratory purposes. I have also mentioned over here the fresh air or the scuba. When you go about towards the geometry of the working space, working area and the confined space, you can perform this job by shifting it. Means a person who is working inside, you just make, let him do the work for some specific period of time and then move him out and then send another person in his place to perform the job, so that the mental stresses or the strains on the muscles of the body will be more relaxing for the person who is working in the confined space. Temperature, you can utilize the fans to make the temperature inside the workspace, confined space, feasible for the person. Oxygen deficiency, as I have told you, how can you cope up with this thing? The light, you can utilize the 24 volts batteries as a light measuring media, so you can perform the jobs. There are some other things which are the part of the working in the confined space, because you are sending some person down where there is no light, there is presence of chances of presence of toxic gases, there is a geometry issue inside that. So you have to continuously monitor the person working in the confined space. How you can monitor this working? You can utilize a buddy system. What is a buddy system? A person is outside standing for you for your monitoring inside, and when you are sending the person down for working in a confined space, what you can do, you can tie a rope to that person who need to work inside and let him go down using some stairs, ladders or some tripods, having some pulleys to lift him up in case of an emergency. So this is the way. The proper way is that if some person is working inside the confined space, the other person who is responsible for supervising him, he need to make sure that this person is in good health. How he can make it sure? when he is performing the job after 5 to 10 minutes, he shakes the rope with which this person is attached, and if he get a response back from the person who is working in the confined space, it means that this person is in a good condition and he's. But if you didn't get a response from that person, what you need to do, you have to move him outside immediately or evacuate him. And for this thing, you have to make a proper emergency response plan, that if something happens to that person, how you can retrieve him back. So this is very important for you. The last thing I also mentioned over here is manage the ERP. ERP, emergency response plan, is very important. Because if you don't have an emergency response, you don't know how to recover this person or how to retrieve this person from the specific place if he suffers some injury or illness while working in the confined space. Some are the precautions which you need to do, as I have told you from the startup. What is the PTW? You have to conduct a PTW and job safety analysis for the specific job. You have to do the gas testing. You have to utilize the buddy system. You have to perform a shift work. You have to use a spark proof tools. You have to make the area barricaded so that no unauthorized person will enter inside that confined space. You have to do a proper supervision using a buddy system. So all of these things are for the confined space, and this confined space, when you have to perform a job in a confined space, make it sure that everything which I have told you in that as a precautionary measures or as a remedial measures for the working, you have to do it, perform it, so that the work will be done in a safe manner. Thank you guys. Thank you.